हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ फ्रिक्शन क्लचेस पार्ट टू। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, टू कंटिन्यू दिस पार्ट यू हैव टू वॉच पार्ट वन। सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट दैट देर आर टू थ्योरीज विच वी अप्लाई ऑन द क्लचेस। व्हेन योर क्लच इज न्यू वी विल अप्लाई यूनिफॉर्म प्रेशर थ्योरी, एंड व्हेन योर क्लच इज ओल्ड वी विल अप्लाई यूनिफॉर्म वियर थ्योरी। सो इन यूनिफॉर्म वियर थ्योरी वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट that pressure is inversely proportional to radius, that is P is equal to C upon R, and normal force on the ring. Now, force, we know that pressure into area, P into 2 pi R into dr. So P is C by R into 2 pi R into dr. So we will cancel R and R, and we will get 2 pi C dr. Total force acting on the friction surface. So this is force on the ring. And the total force will be integral from R2 to R1, that is 2 pi c into dr. So 2 pi c into dr integral, after solving the integral, we can calculate C is equal to W by 2 pi R1 minus R2. So we know that frictional torque. So torque we can write 2 pi mu P R square dr. We have derived in the part 1. So in this case, we will put the value of pressure, that is 2 pi mu C by R square into dr. So after that, we will calculate 2 pi mu CR into DR. So total frictional torque acting on the friction surface or on the clutch. So this is a torque on the ring, and after integral, we will calculate the total torque, and solving it, we can get the value of mu WR, where R is R1 plus R2 1 by 2. So R is R1 plus R2 by 2, that is mean radius of the friction surface. So these are some formulas that we have derived in the first part and second part. That torque on the clutch is equal to N mu WR, where N is number of pairs of friction surfaces, and it is 2 because both sides of the clutch plate are friction surfaces. R is mean radius of friction surface. In case of uniform pressure, we will use this formula. In case of uniform wear, we will use this formula. So for single disc or plate clutch, normally both sides of the disc are effective. Therefore, single disc clutch has 2 pairs of surfaces in contact, that is N is equal to 2. So another formula that we have discussed is max pressure is maximum at R2. So P max is equal to C by R2, and pressure is minimum at R1. So P minimum is equal to C by R1. So now multiple disc clutch, the formula we use for the multiple disc clutch is same as that of the single plate clutch, that is N mu WR, but the value of N will change, but rest of the things will remain same. So N will be N1 plus N2 minus 1. N1 is number of discs on the driving shaft, N2 is number of discs on the driven shaft. So as you can see, this is your driven shaft, the blue one. So this is your driving shaft. So you can see in your driving shaft, how many plates are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And on your driven shaft, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 and 5, 10 minus 1, 9. So N will be 9 in case of this clutch. So we will solve it in numerical, you will understand in a better way. So multiple disc clutch is actually designed to overcome the limitation of single plate clutch, in which the torque is less. So in multiple disc clutch, you can get more torque by not having a larger diameter of the clutch plate. You can keep the diameter of the clutch small, and you can still transmit large amount of torque, and it is mostly used in bikes. So let's solve the question. Determine maximum minimum pressure in a clutch plate plate clutch when the axial force is 4 kN, inside radius of the contact surface is 50 mm and outside radius is 100 mm. Assume uniform wear. So this is the given data. Load given 4 kN, or we can say 4000 Newton. R2 outside dia, inside dia is 50, and R1 outside dia is 100. So first of all, calculate maximum pressure. Maximum pressure, you have written that that pressure is maximum at inside radius R2. So P max into R2 is equal to C. So C will be 50 into P max, because R2 is 50. So you can put the value of load. This is the formula we have derived in the uniform wear case. Like here you can see, this is the formula for W. W is equal to 2 pi C R1 minus R2. So put the value of W is equal to 2 pi C R1 minus R2. W is 4000 given to us. 2 pi C is 50 into P max R1 minus R2. In this calculation, we can get P max. So this is your answer for the maximum pressure. Similarly, minimum pressure is P minimum into R1 into C. So you can apply same formula, W is equal to 2 pi C R1 minus R2, and put the value of C and you can calculate P minimum. Then average pressure is force upon area, load upon area. You can put the values and also calculate average pressure. So this is your second question. A plate clutch having a single driving plate with contact surfaces on each side is required to transmit 110 kilowatt at 1250 RPM. So torque and RPM are given. Sorry, power and RPM are given. So you can calculate torque. The outer diameter of the contact surfaces is to be 300 mm. Coefficient of friction is 0.4. So this is the given data. Assuming a uniform pressure of 0.17 Newton per mm square, determine the inner diameter of the friction surfaces. So let's solve the first part. So given is power, RPM, you can calculate torque. So first of all, power and RPM, we will use P into 60 by 2 pi n and calculate the torque. Then diameter, outside diameter is given, we convert it into radius. Coefficient of friction is given, pressure is given, and we need to calculate diameter inside, that is R2, out inside radius. So you have calculated torque, and you know that load is equal to pressure into area. So put the value of pressure and R1, but R2 is not given to us. And another thing you have to calculate is capital R, and it is 2 by 3 R1 cube minus R2 cube by R1 square minus R2 square. This is the case of uniform pressure theory. So we will put the value of R1 here. So torque, we have derived the formula that torque is equal to N mu W into R. So N is 2 because both sides are friction surfaces. Mu is 0.4. W is here we have calculated in terms of R2. R, capital R, here we have calculated in terms of R2. So this is the single equation with single variable, and you have to calculate R2 for here. So R2 after calculation will be 75, or you can say diameter will be 150. So maximum torque transmitted. Second thing we need to calculate, assuming same dimensions and same total axial thrust, determine maximum torque transmitted and maximum intensity of pressure when uniform wear condition. So now we will have to apply uniform wear condition here. So load we can calculate after putting the value of R2, that is 9011. And for uniform wear, R is R1 plus R2 by 2. Put the value of R1 and R2 and get capital R 112.5. So torque transmitted, you apply the formula and get the answer. And maximum intensity of pressure. So you know that pressure is maximum at inner radius, that is R2. So P max into R2 is equal to C. After putting the value of C, after putting the value of R2, the C will be P max into 75. So now we have known the formula. We have calculated the derived the formula that W is equal to 2 pi C R1 minus R2. After putting the values of C and R1 and R2, you can easily calculate maximum pressure. So this is the question for multi-disc clutch. It has three discs on the driving shaft and two on the driven. So total discs are 5 and N will be 4. The inside diameter of the contact surface is 120. Maximum pressure is 0.1. Design the clutch transmitting 25 kilowatt power at 1575 RPM. Assume uniform wear condition. Coefficient of friction is 0.3. We have written the given data, calculated the torque from power and RPM, and it is 151600 Newton mm. So we will apply the uniform wear theory here. And uniform wear theory is P max, maximum pressure is at inside radius, and load is 2 pi C R1 minus R2. So N we have already discussed, it is 4. So torque transmitted is, we apply the formula. Here we have calculated torque 151600 N mu W into R. N is 4, mu is 0.3. W we have calculated from 2 pi C R1 minus R2. R1 is not given to us. And capital R we have taken it from R1 plus R2 by 2. R1 we have to calculate. So after solving this equation, R1 will be 101.5. So this completes your friction clutches. In your next videos, we will cover cone clutches. Thank you, guys.